Hello everyone, welcome to Math Advice. In this video, let me discuss how to solve an unbalanced assignment problem if the objective function is of maximization. Sometimes the assignment problem may deal with maximization of the objective function instead of minimization. So in such cases, we have to convert first maximization to minimization problem. Then we have to proceed as usual in case of minimization assignment problem. So how we have to convert this maximization to minimization is, for that we have to follow two ways. Either by subtracting all the elements from the highest element of the matrix, or by multiplying the matrix elements by minus 1. We can choose any one of these ways to convert this maximization assignment problem to minimization assignment problem. That is, we have to convert the profit matrix. If the objective function is of maximization, then that cost matrix is nothing but our profit matrix. We have to convert that profit matrix to loss matrix. So for that, here we have to choose this method, that is, by subtracting all elements from the highest element of the matrix, we have to convert the profit matrix to loss matrix and proceed as usual. Let me now move on to an example. Solve the following assignment problem to maximize profit. Look at here, the objective is maximize profit. To apply Hungarian method, we have to first check the two conditions, whether the given function is of minimization and if it is balanced. So to apply Hungarian method, we have to first check whether the given function is of minimization type and is of balanced one. If it is minimization and balanced, then only we make use of the Hungarian algorithm to find the optimum assignment schedule. Look at this problem, it is of maximization. So first we have to convert this maximization to minimization. So for that, we have to choose the highest cost element in this cost matrix. So look at all the elements of this matrix. Here the highest cost element is 111. So we have to subtract this highest cost element from all elements of the matrix. Then this profit matrix is converted into loss matrix. In such case, the objective function is of minimization. For this profit matrix, your objective function is of maximization. So by subtracting the highest cost element 111, we have to convert this profit matrix to loss matrix. So the maximization objective is converted to minimization. The next one, let me check whether the given problem is of balanced one or not. So look at the R of the matrix. Here there are 4 jobs and 5 machines. So it is a 4 by 5 matrix. That is, it has 4 rows and 5 columns. You know already, if number of rows is not equal to number of columns, then that is unbalanced. So to make it balanced, we introduce either dummy row or dummy column. So in this problem, since we have only 4 rows, we introduce one more dummy row to convert this into a balanced matrix. So if we introduce one more dummy row, then the order of the matrix now become 5 by 5, and I am going to label this as 5, job 5. 5 by 5 matrix, then we have to proceed as usual. So first thing what we are going to do here is, we convert first its maximization to minimization, and then we have to introduce a dummy row to convert this unbalanced assignment problem to balanced assignment problem. And let me know, then we have to move on to a step 1 of Hungarian algorithm to proceed further. So first I am going to convert this profit matrix to loss matrix. For that, I have to choose the highest cost element here. The highest cost element is 111. So we have to subtract 111 from all the elements of this matrix. Then the matrix here we get as, so when we subtracting 111 minus 62, 49, 111 minus 78, 33, 111 minus 50, 61, 111 minus 101, 10, and 111 minus 82, 29. Like this, we have to subtract this value with other elements, we get this matrix. This is our last matrix. So here the objective function is of minimization type. So the first condition we have verified. So we convert this into the profit matrix to last matrix. So we get the objective function is of minimization type. Next we have to check the R of the matrix. Since it's a 4 by 5 matrix, we have introduced one more dummy row to introduce, sorry, to make it as a balanced assignment problem. So the next step, we have to introduce a dummy row. This is the fifth row is a dummy row. Now the matrix is a balanced one. So we make use of Hungarian algorithm to find the optimum assignment schedule now. So as a first step of Hungarian method, we have to check whether each row has at least one zero element or not. Look at the first row. It doesn't have any zero element, so you have to pick up the minimum element. So 10 is the minimum element. So next row, we have to check, is there any zero element? So doesn't have any zero element, so pick up the minimum element. Here the minimum element is 27. Look at the third row, it has zero element, so leave this. Move on to the fourth row. So this row doesn't have any zero element, so the here the minimum element is 24. So now we have to write down the row minima. So 10 is the minimum element for the first row, 27 is the minimum element for the second row, third row has zero element, so leave this. Fourth row, 24 is the minimum element, and last row also has a zero element, leave this. Now we have to subtract these minimum elements from its corresponding row entries. We have to subtract these minimum elements from its corresponding row entries. We get this matrix. So let me start with the first row. When we subtracting 10 from first row elements, that is 49 minus 10, 39, 33 minus 10, 23, 61 minus 10, 51, 10 minus 10, 0, and 29 minus 10, 19. And for the second row, we have to subtract second row elements from minus 27. We get this this value. So like this, write down the third row elements as it is and subtract 63 minus 24, 47 minus 24, 24 minus 24, 34 minus 24, 31 minus 24. After subtracting, we get these values. So in this matrix, let me now check whether each column also has at least one zero element. Look at the first column, second column, third column, fourth column, and fifth column. Here, all column has zero elements. So we move on to directly for making assignment. So now the matrix is ready for making assignment. So for making assignment, as usual, first write down the number of zeros outside of the matrix. First row has only one zero, second row also has one zero, third row has one zero, and fourth row has one zero, and fifth row has five zero elements. So we have to give our first assignment either to the first row, second row, third row, or fourth row, since it all has only one zero. So I have to choose the first row first for making my assignment. After making assignment, cross the remaining zero elements in the same row and column. Row wise it doesn't have any zero element, column wise it has only one zero, so cross this zero element. Next, we move on to the second row. So I'm going to make the assignment at this position. After making assignment, cross the remaining zero elements in the same row and column. Next, row wise it doesn't have any zero element, whereas column wise it has only one zero element, so cross this zero element. Next we move on to the third row. I'm going to make assignment at this position. After making assignment, cross the remaining zero elements in the same column and also row wise. So column wise it has 2 0, cross these zeros, and row wise doesn't have any zero element. Next we move on to the next assignment. Fourth row now doesn't have any zero elements. So let's now move on to the last row. Here we have two possibilities for making assignment. Either I am going to make an assignment at this position or at this position. So arbitrarily I have to choose this position for making assignment, and I have to cross this zero element in the same row and column wise. Now, after making assignment, check whether each row has exactly one assignment or not. First row has an assignment at this position, whereas second row has an assignment at this position. Third row also has an assignment at this position, whereas the fourth row doesn't have any assignment. And the fifth row has an assignment at this position. So, except fourth row, all the rows has an assignment. So, which means the current assignment is not optimal. So, we move on to the next step. In the next step, what we are going to do is we have to draw minimum number of straight lines which cover all zero elements. Now we have to draw minimum number of straight lines to cover all zero elements. For that, you have to mark the row which doesn't have any zero element. Sorry. For that, you have to mark the row which doesn't have any assignment. So the fourth row doesn't have any assignment, so you mark this row. After marking this row, check whether is there any zero element. Here there is a zero element, so you mark this corresponding column. This is your second step. After marking this column, in this column check, is there any assignment? In this column there is an assignment at this position. If so, you mark this corresponding row. This is your third step. So mark the row which doesn't have any assignment. And in this row, is there any zero element? Means you mark this corresponding column. In this column, is there any assignment? Means you have to mark this corresponding row. After this, you have to draw a straight line through all unmarked rows. First, second and last row are unmarked row, whereas the third and fourth are marked rows, and draw a straight line through marked column. So you have to draw a straight line through unmarked rows and marked column. Let me show this matrix clearly to you now. So this is what we have did so far. So we have to draw a straight line through unmarked row and marked column. After this, we have to pick up the minimum element from the uncovered elements. So these are all elements not covered by any of the straight lines. These are all the elements not covered by any of the straight lines. So among these, you have to choose the minimum element. Here the minimum element is 7 is the minimum element. The next step, we have to subtract 7 from all uncovered elements, and you have to add this 7, that is minimum element, to the point of intersection of the straight lines. So at these three positions, are the point of intersection of these straight lines. So at these three positions, you have to add the minimum value 7 and write down the remaining element as it is. Now let me subtract 7 from all uncovered element first. For that, let me start with the third row. 24 minus 7, that is 17. 19 minus 7, 12. And at this position, 40 minus 7, 33, 30 minus 7, 23, and for the fourth row, 39 minus 7, 32, 23 minus 7, 16, 10 minus 7, 3, 7 minus 7, 0. Then we have to add 7 to the point of intersection of the straight line. So at these three positions, we have to add 7. First row, 5 plus 7, 12. Next, for the second row, 23 plus 7, 13, and for the last two, 0 plus 7, 7. And we are writing down the remaining elements as it is. So for the first row, 39, 23, at this position we have 0, 19. Then for the second row, 13, 0, and 11, 25. And for the third row, here we have 0, here fourth row, here we have 0, and for the last row, we have 0, 0, 0. Now we are going to make an assignment as usual. First we have to write down the number of zeros first. First row has only 1 0, second row has 1 0, third row has 1 0, whereas fourth row has 2 0 and last row has 4 0. So as usual, no need to write down the number of zeros outside of the matrix like that. This is for your understanding purpose. You just keep that in mind and count the number of zeros in each row first and make the assignment for the row which has less number of zeros compared with the other row. Now, we have to make our first assignment either for the first row, second row or third row. Since it all has only one zeros. Arbitrarily, I have to choose the first row for making my first assignment. I am going to make an assignment at this position. After making assignment, cross the remaining zero elements in the same row and column. Next we move on to the second row. I am going to make an assignment at this position. After making assignment, you cross the remaining zero elements in the same row and column is 2. Next we move on to the third row. I make an assignment at this position. After making assignment, cross the remaining zero elements in the same column and row wise. Next, the fourth row has only one zero at this position, so I make an assignment at this position. So cross the zero element in the same column and row is 2, whereas the last row now has only one zero element, so we have only one possibility for making assignment at this position alone. So I am going to make assignment at this position. After making assignment, cross the remaining zero elements in the same row and column. Now, after making assignment, check whether each row has exactly one assignment or not. First row has an assignment at this position. Second row also has an assignment at this position. Third row also has an assignment at this position. Fourth row has an assignment at this position. And fifth row has an assignment at this position. Which means the current assignment schedule is an optimum one. So the optimum assignment schedule is job 1 is assigned with machine D. Job 2, that is 1 to D. Job 2 is assigned with machine B, that is 2 to B. Job 3 is assigned with machine C, that is 3 to C. Job 4 is assigned with E, that is 4 to E. And job 5 is assigned with A, that is 5 to A. Next, we have to find out the original cost associated with this position. So, we need the cost associated with this position. For that, we just look at the given matrix. This is one the given matrix, that is a profit matrix. This is a given matrix. So, after using the Hungarian method, we arrive this reduced matrix. So, after applying Hungarian method to this matrix, we get the reduced matrix here. So, and we arrive at the assignment schedule at these positions. Now we need the cost associated with this portions. So 1 to D, here we have 101, 2 to B, 0, 3 to Z, 111, 4 to E, that is 80, and 5 to A. Since we are given an unbalanced one, so we have, here we add a dummy row and make it balanced and convert it to a balanced one, and we make use of Hungarian algorithm. So the cost associated with this position is 0. So adding all these values together, we get the maximum profit. So the maximum profit is 101 plus 84 plus 111 plus 80 plus 0, which equals 376, isn't it? Let's
So for the given assignment problem, we have arrived the optimum assignment schedule. So job 1 is assigned with D, 2 to B, 3 to C, 4 to E and 5 to A. And the profit associated, that is maximum profit associated with this assignment schedule is rupees 376. And here 5 to A means job 5 is assigned with machine A. Here for fifth row is our dummy row, isn't it? It is our dummy row, which means machine A is assigned with a dummy job. So machine A is left without any assignment. That is the conclusion. Since we are given only 4 rows and 5 columns, so one of the machine is left without any assignment. Here the machine A is having assignment at the 5th row. So which means this machine is left without any assignment. Now I am going to give you one more problem for your practice, self-practice. So take this problem and do it well. I am just giving you a hint of this problem. This is similar to the problem which we have discussed earlier. Look at this problem, it is of maximization type. So first convert this matrix to last matrix. For that you have to subtract the highest cost element, that is look at all the elements. Here the highest cost element is 18. Just by subtracting 18, so convert this profit matrix to last matrix. Then the objective function is converted to maximization to minimization. After this, look at rows and columns. Since it has only 4 rows, so you introduce one more dummy row with 0 cost elements. So now the matrix has become balanced one and you make use of the Hungarian algorithm. So after this, you make use of the Hungarian algorithm to find the optimum assignment schedule. Whatever may be the assignment schedule you have arrived, you have get the profit associated with that as rupees 64. This is for your self-practice. So do it well. So after calculating the assignment schedule and its associated bus, you have to get a clear idea about how to solve an unbalanced assignment problem in case of maximization type. Hope you got a clear idea about how to solve an unbalanced assignment problem if the objective function is of maximization type. Thanks for watching. See you again in my next video.